Grace and You Cooking Show segment is brought to you by Grace Kennedy Belize Limited, bringing good taste to life.
And welcome back. And it's time for another edition of Flavor with a Beat.
That's right.
Of course, we're here in the Grace Kitchen. And Chef Dwain, you're going to be cooking up something special?
Yes, man. We're going to do some nice, we're using our fish.
Ah.
You know, we're in the month of Lent, right?
That's right.
Right. And we're bringing back the season for fish, Friday.
Yeah.
Right.
Friday is fish day.
Friday is fish day. All right. So what we have is nice fillet, thanks to my friends out there in San Pedro. Mm. Nice fresh caught snapper. Look at that. Very nice.
Beautiful.
Very fresh, not smelly. Don't be afraid to smell your fish. That's the only way.
Yeah.
That's the only way you're gonna know. If your fish, you get it and the eye is white and you check the gills, if you see it's pink or something like that, step away from it. Sticky and stuff like that, step away from it. But try to get that. I try to get some elusive lionfish, but it's very hard.
Yeah.
It's very hard. I think they're just getting into it. San Pedro is just getting into it, and Sartaneja is just getting into it. And
I think usually when the lobster season closes, then people go into
other mode.
Yeah.
Because you know our Easter time that they get your fried fish, get your all that stuff going
and
on.
And every
right?
Friday, everybody's looking for a new way to prepare the fish. So we'll give them a recipe.
We'll give them an easy, simple recipe. I have some water boiling right here.
Okay.
All right. I have some chocho as a little side. Nothing heavy.
Okay.
Just as a side dish. There's an onion
flavor,
right? Mm-hmm. Right? This fish, we're gonna saute it down.
Okay.
And we add spinach.
I know, there's a cream spinach
there's
sauce.
There's a cream spinach. This thing, you could grow this in your backyard. It's very easy. It's very wild. It's very nutritious. You know, you could have it in shakes. You could do all kinds of stuff. You can make a spinach salad. Mm-hmm. Get out there, use it. Just think of it as lettuce. Just think of it as lettuce. You're making a burger or something like that. Forget the lettuce, get something more protein, more fibrous for you. Mm-hmm. All right, it's filled with fiber. Use it as a lettuce.
Yeah.
And your burgers.
That would
all right?
work.
It's very easy and it's more nutritious for us, right? Mm-hmm. All right.
So we're doing fish. This is the side you said, but this looks like it's been seasoned as well. What did you put in there?
It's just onion
and
my chocho as a side.
Okay.
All right, siding meaning that it will come up eventually.
Okay.
What we call all this here, before you start your cooking, you call it mise en place, right? Mise en place is very simple. It's just getting yourself together.
Okay.
All right. You get that all set out. You know, you have this, you have that. Get it all together because sometime your recipe is spoiled, right? All right. So we got this nice fillet here, but we won't ruin it by, you know, you're adding too much salt, adding too much things. So we brought our...
There you go.
It's back, right?
Of course.
It's back. It's very easy. People say, Dwain, you have to do that one more time. The magic paper. I can't believe it. Take the guesswork out of sprinkling too much this or too much that or, you know, want to taste it from the end. But this stuff is ready to go, right?
You know what I love too? The easy cleanup.
The easy cleanup, right? And it's more healthier.
Yeah.
It's more healthier. They're available now in stores. People are asking all over the place for it. And we're gonna combine it with fish tea.
Oh,
Grace has brought out fish tea.
So this is fish flavoring.
That's right. Mm-hmm. It has in okra, it has in everything in there. Mm-hmm. All right? Made from real fish flavor. Mm-hmm. All right? So which one do we wanna use? That's
so
up to you.
We have herbs, the herbs. We have black pepper and we have
garlic and onions. All right?
Let's go with herbs. This,
yes, can't go wrong, all right?
So once again, this is so easy. You literally just wrap it in the paper.
Okay.
This is no-brainer cooking.
There you go. That's why I like with Grace. They make it so easy that, get the kids involved. We got 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah.
As you can see, these.
They have the oil and the seasoning.
The oil in and seasoning in and everything else. All right. And everybody asking, where you get this, where you get that? Bring it back again. Well, here we go. Yeah. Here we go. Make the chef life easy. Soon we won't have a chef in the kitchen, right?
So we used it on chicken before. Now we're going to try it on fish.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right. So I'm just going to cut this up. Yeah. Get out there. Get some nice fresh fish. could be the tilapia. The tilapia they're growing right now is very good.
Okay.
It is very good. It's not that muddy type they had before.
The farm one?
It's the farm one. The tank is on the cement, right? So I'm just gonna stick that in here. Mm-hmm. Let's do three in here.
Do we need to turn
and I'll put this aside for right now.
Okay.
All right. Okay. And put another one in here.
All you're gonna
that's
have
all
to
you're
do.
Gonna have to do.
I tell you,
right.
It's magic paper.
And that's it. All right. Gonna clean my hands right here. No. Mm-hmm.
So the fish is marinating.
Marinating. So easy. You see how long that take?
All right.
So I'm gonna have a clean board. Mm-hmm. All right. Remember, with fish, you always want to keep it clean.
Yeah.
All right. All right. So with that, you see that? All you gotta do is turn that over. Mm-hmm. All right. So we have a clean side. Good.
So we have our fish marinating. Mm-hmm. We gotta get into, I guess, the cream sauce.
The cream sauce, which is very easy.
You always say that, but you're a chef.
There you go. The sauce, this is called a bechamel sauce. It's okay. A very basic sauce. It's a sauce used for the Alfredo, but it takes a long while to prepare. I wouldn't have the time to bring it out here.
Okay.
So I'm going semi-homemade. We call it semi-homemade cooking, which Grace does. You mind passing me a spoon here so I could take these stuff out here?
Sure.
Voila. All right.
Oh, here's the spoon. Mm-hmm. We're taking this out?
Yes.
Where do you want to put it?
Let's pop it right up here.
Okay, so we got our chocho.
Except the onion. See, this stuff you do it before.
So you just boil that.
Boil that down. All right, the onion.
Okay.
All right, I'm going to take a nice generous bunch of spinach.
You've already washed it.
Yes, yeah. Wash it very good. It carries sand. It's like lettuce, remember? The veins and stuff carry sand. And a bunch of this spinach goes a long way. What we do in the big restaurants, we get a whole 3-4 pounds and we just boil it, strain it, dry it out, and freeze it.
Oh, so you have it prepared all the time?
It's already prepared all the time. It's on demand, so we have it prepared all the time, right? Mm-hmm. That doesn't take long.
Yeah.
Because you can soak that down there.
So what we really do is like, we're trying to get it to wilt.
Get it to, right.
Does that change the flavor?
That does change the flavor because like you said here in the Caribbean, our spinach is very, very strong.
Yeah, we got potent
spinach. It's potent spinach. Eating a handful of spinach is very strong for the whole day. Right? And you could mask it. Mm-hmm. You mask it with different flavoring. You have apple, you have raisin, you got
She
like her peanut butter girl.
Yeah.
All right? So I'm just gonna switch around. Okay?
Okay.
Get this fish going. All right? Mm. So we could pop this over here. This spinach is already done.
Yeah.
All right? So I'll just put this on here to get this hot and going.
So we're wilting the spinach for the start of the sauce.
Right, okay. Right. Let me just add the rest of that in here.
Yeah, there's no space.
All right. You cut off the stems. The stems are very fibrous. They're very chewy. They're not they're edible, but it'll take a while to get used to that one. All right?
So there we have another chef trick.
Right.
So we're boiling an onion in
with
the
an
water.
Onion in it, yes. Onion is flavor.
Yeah.
We'll take the fish tea.
Uh-huh.
All right. I'm gonna pop that in there
what
by now.
What is happening here?
Right.
Oh, more flavor.
More flavoring. That's what I'm enhancing, right?
All right.
Okay. Good. So you got the frying pan nice and hot. Mm-hmm. Wait, how you know that hot, right?
No, I wouldn't put my hand on it. Oh, okay. I thought you were telling me I have to touch it with my hand.
No, this is the way you know how it's hot, right? So you got the steam, you got the bubbles.
I do like the hover above,
No, that's good.
Okay.
All right? Excellent. Always want to keep your handle away from all of this going on. Mm-hmm. Accidents happen. A lot of accidents happen in the kitchen. I've seen it.
I believe you.
Keep the handle away, right? You're boiling something in the back. Turn it away.
Okay.
Right? You're cooking something when you finish. Move it away, right?
All right?
Perfect. Okay. So, get the oil. What oil? Get
Don't
the paper
eat.
Oil. All right? I'm doing this
and
with
fish. Cook so fast.
Very
so.
Rapid. Very rapid. All right? Mm-mm. Good. So we have all that flavor in there, you know.
So we have our fish cooking, mm-hmm. and of course, once again, we use the magic sheets, magic as sheets. I call them, mm-hmm. but they're seasoned papers that mm-hmm. come with the oil and the seasoning already on it. What's your favorite flavor?
The same one, the herbs.
The herbs, yeah.
I just can't see myself not using that.
Yeah.
Everybody, that's the only one you use, Dwain. Yes. Yeah. Or the herbs is very good, man. It's, yeah. it's, you should have that every day. You should eat some herb every day.
Yeah.
Every day. Belize, you go to the market, you see a lot of spinach, you see kalalu, you see chaya.
Yeah.
Same family.
Yeah.
Get into it. Get into it.
How long would this take to cook?
Okay, it's each side, we're doing like for 5-6 minutes on each side. That
okay.
will give you roughly 12.
Okay.
10, 12. All right. All right. So we could take
I think
this
that's
off.
Done.
Yeah. Take this off. I'm going to my blender here.
Okay.
All right. Everything is in the blender, man. Very easy.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
So you want me to put this in there?
Okay. You want to come over here and do it more safer? Always practice safely. You could put that. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So not only does it have the flavor mm-hmm. of the onion, it also has the flavor of the spinach.
That's right.
I mean, of the soup.
The soup. The fish tea.
Fish tea.
Fish tea. I want to get
obviously, people would eat that too. That's what it
that's
is.
That's right.
It's an instant soup.
You got two things. You got yeah. the appetizer soup before the entree right here at Grace. Makes it easy. But I'll get some of that good stuff on the bottom there.
Okay.
All right? I want to get some of the good stuff on the bottom. Strain? No strain. Don't throw away this stuff. This is a good stock. Mm-hmm. What I get into is... the fish tea would be the fish stock,
okay.
right? Or as we call it in our world, broth.
Okay.
Broth are very good. You make broth every day and people don't even know it. Broth is just a nice, like you're having a cup of soup with all that stuff in there,
mm-hmm.
but you have flavor, right? Mm-hmm. So we have some pasta in there. We have some carrot in there. There's okra in there. Cilantro in there, you know. All right. And this is a good stock. This is a good broth. A cup of broth a day is very excellent.
Mm.
It is very excellent. It's very healthy. All right. So I want to flip these over. Let me lower this down a little bit.
What do we use this?
Yeah, we could use that. Or we have a spatula or a flat spoon somewhere around there. There you go. Voila.
I don't trust myself with that part. You do that.
Believe it, guys, this fish is almost there.
I know.
It's almost there. That's like, what, 3 minutes?
Yeah, I can see it from the corners. It's, mm-hmm. it's cooking fast.
It's going in there. All right, so we have your spinach in there. A little bit of spinach with your fish tea.
Uh-huh.
And everything else in there. You know we don't got no salt, no black pepper going in here,
I realize
right?
that.
You realize that, right? But we have one of my favorite herb, cilantro.
Yes.
Now, why I didn't boil the cilantro in with the spinach? Because I want that robust.
Yeah.
I want it to bring out, I want it to hide the spinach.
Yeah.
All right?
And it's most flavorful when it's fresh.
Exactly, yeah. exactly. Belizean, then cilantro. Oh, no, mm-hmm. no come between them and that cilantro, right? All right, so the cream, this is half cream.
Okay.
Half cream could be other cream brands out there.
Yeah.
All right? And we're gonna add this to it and that will be it. All right?
Mm-hmm.
Depending on your texture you like. All right.
There you go.
Okay. Voila. So I'm going to add, now I'm going to add some more of that water. See?
That's where your stock mm-hmm, comes mm-hmm, in. Mm-hmm. Okay, how much do you want me to put?
Add like four.
Four?
Look at that flavor on that. Look how, instead of just using water from, you
know. And
it's
going to add so much more flavor.
That's right. And you put that up. And you use it to cook with also.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Instead of using water, you make stock. You make broth. You can put it in ice cubes, you put it up, freeze it, make it easier for you in your kitchen. All right? All right. One spinach.
So we have cream, we have the fish soup, and we have the boiled spinach.
Mm-hmm. All right, let's give this a whirl here. All right.
Ooh.
All right. So we have a spinach colada. Mm-hmm. All right.
No, that's not one you're gonna drink.
Oh yeah, we're wrong show. Wrong show. The spinach colada.
And
just
that's like, it. That's your
that,
sauce.
That will be it. That will be the sauce. See how easy that was.
Yeah.
But let me transfer it to another frying pan.
Okay.
All right. Should be one frying pan, but you know me, I like make mess, which is excellent. So you give your kitchen helper a good job, right? If you don't make the mess, your kitchen helper doesn't learn anything. Because then when you go wash this, let me taste that. That's where you learn.
Now we know what it's like. This is okay?
Yes. I'm going on one. So now we know why the kitchen helper becomes, this dishwasher becomes a chef, right? Because they taste all the frying pan and everything in the background, right? All right, so hot.
Not yet.
All right.
But this is done. This the is, fish
that,
is done.
That is done, all right?
As easy as...
As easy as one, two, three. Spinach colada, look at that nice, creamy. It looks
I don't
almost,
know about a colada, but it does look like a nice sauce.
All right, what this will do is it will break down.
Yeah.
And we'll thicken.
Yeah.
All right? So that's all we got right there. All right?
So that's so easy.
It is so easy.
You just put the fish stock, well, the fish soup, and the cream and the cooked spinach in there, blend it up. And you could do this with chicken too.
Oh yes, you could do this with a, you could take this on and on.
Or a pasta.
Or a pasta, there you go. Cream of spinach pasta is excellent. You want to cook it and it gets real nice and thick. All right. What you go for flavor, all right. I'm gonna have a little taste here.
So the reason we didn't have to put any salt or pepper in here was because we had the fish soup, which already had its own seasonings.
Right, see? You're good. You're good.
Easier.
And the fish is already seasoned.
So you don't
also
have to worry about putting in too much salt.
Too much salt, right. All right, there's fire. You want to stir this around. It's a little thin right now.
Yeah.
You want it to hold. All right, that's why the other sauce, the original bechamel sauce, takes so long because it's a lot of stirring.
That's the one that you whisk?
Whisk, right, with the, you put the cloves and the onion, you get a nice, then you could break that down into Alfredo, you could break that down into cream sauce, you could break that down into a bunch of stuff in your kitchen.
Yeah, we're not all chefs, we won't do bechamel sauce So this is so much easier to just use cream.
Just cream.
And some good stock.
And some good, yes. Keep your stock, guys. Don't throw it away.
Yeah.
You're cutting onions. At the end of the onions, you're cutting cilantro. Keep it all together. Throw it in a pot. Boil it. If you got chicken bones, you make chicken stock. You got beef, you got beef stock. And very easy. Without all that salt. Without all that. You know how much herbs we're having here this morning, right? This fish is very healthy.
Yeah.
Spinach. The only thing we'll throw it back is offset the cream. But hey, we could live with that, all right?
Yeah. Unfortunately, the cream can't be healthy, but but it's still delicious.
It is still delicious, all right?
Yeah, we see how that's starting to get thicker
now. Yeah, it's starting to get thick. That's the only...
Does it still taste very, very spinachy?
No, it's blanched out. It's already taken care of already. All right, we'll get you some later on. All right? And remember, milk, once you say white milk cream, it bubbles. The lactose in it coming out and it boils.
Okay.
So don't turn your back on milk. Never turn your back on milk. All right? Because it will come over the frying pan. It will come over the frying pan. Right? It's like going to chocolate school. I turn my back and second.
Burnt.
Very easy. Milk. The lactose.
Yeah.
Hi.
Well, if anybody has any fudge experience, they know that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And I'm sure we all have some battle scars
those
from
days,
fudge.
Those days, yes. Granny said, not touch the fudge. Wait till it cool. No.
But it smells so good.
Yes. Burnt milk. All right.
So once again, of course, we know a lot of people are having fish on Fridays. And so this is an easy recipe you can try at home. You don't have to go to a restaurant to get it. We literally made it in the sauce in like 5 minutes. And I really love the suggestion that you have in cooking it in the fish soup itself, because that's going to give it some great flavor.
Right. Keep your stocks going. Like I said, freeze it. You don't got nothing to eat. You come home, you take out one cup of stock. Mm-hmm. You sieve it, you clear it. Mm-hmm. What will happen, you put it in your fridge, what will happen, the oil will come up on top. Because it will have oil.
Yeah.
It will have oil. Take that off, it's frozen. Put that up. Mm-hmm. Don't throw it away. Use it in a frying pan for eggs, for something else. Uh-huh. All right, it's a cooking process that we go through. There's a lot, all right?
All the special chef tips that we're learning
that's
today.
What I want to shout out my peeps out there. Says, Dwain, you taught me something. Every time I watch your show, you tell me something. I said, guys, keep on watching, all right?
What's the one recipe everybody always asks you about?
The same thing, the Alfredo sauce. Everybody's up to the Alfredo sauce. Well, the jerk is getting there, you know? But every time we have newcomers, Grace brings out newcomers. Uh-huh. They're up to a new batch of frozen stuff they're doing now.
Okay.
There's a bunch of stuff coming out.
Oh.
They're getting ready for this big Easter. Look out for them in your supermarkets and stuff like that. You know, they're the company that goes out and gives you something else to try. Here, try this, you know?
So that means we have some really interesting recipes coming up on Flavor with a Beat. Mm-hmm.
Flavor with a Beat. The beat is going on, right?
Mm-hmm. And, you know, you were supposed to dance, right?
That's
right. Where is the dance in your cooking today?
The music is on and we're dancing. After you eat this, trust me, you're going to do the Flavor Beat dance, right? You notice how long while this takes to get its...
To get thick.
Yeah. But it's getting there, right?
Yeah.
You can do it as long as how thick you want it. Mm-hmm. I like a real nice thick sauce that just hangs.
Okay.
If not, you can let the fish swim back in the sauce. But, all right? Good. Make it feel like it's still
alive.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. All right. We just clear up here on aisle four.
All right.
Okay.
And so the chocho that you cooked earlier is actually going to be the side
just
for
the
this
side,
dish.
Right. You could add your rice, you add your potatoes, you know, you could do. But I love chocho, I'm keeping it very healthy, all right? Keep it very nice. Mm. Okay. So remember, fish, Fridays, get out there, try different things.
We told you early enough, so you can't forget, right?
That's right. Try different.
Don't forget that you're supposed to have fish today.
Try different things, get out there and try different things, mm-hmm. Okay? Good, we're done with that.
I think so. Yeah. This is nice and thick.
All right, so we're gonna bring the fish back in the paper.
There you go.
Okay,
got it? It's not hot, yeah.
Voila, and the paper is open.
Jummy.
You got that? Nice.
You want this?
That's okay, I'll just hand it out. Okay.
I've stolen all your tools, they're on the other side.
All right, look at that, real nice, real healthy, not oily, not swimming in oil. The flavor is excellent. We're gonna do our scratch TV and you could smell it coming through the screen and everything else, working on that. Perfect, let's get this wrapped up.
Speaking of delicious, this sauce looks so good.
Mm-hmm. And you could just spoon it on right there.
Okay. So just on top?
Just on top. Around the sides, let it swim in there.
Oh, I haven't learned the garnishing technique as yet, but we'll try something.
That will all come together, right?
Let's hope so.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Let me add some more.
Okay, you all go
right,
ahead.
Let me add some more, because the sauce is so nice, right?
Mmm.
You smell that sauce?
Yes.
It's not, if you try to hide from the spinach, this is not the one you want to do that, right? All right, I just put that up there for a little garnishing and also for a nice flavor.
Oh.
And for me, that would be a complete dish. And very simple. Very simple. Starch, potato, almost similar.
Mm-hmm.
Fish, healthy.
Yeah, some great protein
and
there.
Great protein, and it's very easy.
And you got your flavor from your cream spinach.
There's a lot, bunch of flavors in there, all right?
And of course, your garnish.
And of course, a little sprig.
There you have it.
Voila.
Fish fillet in cream spinach sauce. Easy to make. We made it from scratch completely right here. And quite a number of tools that made it so much easier, including the seasoned paper, which, I just think that's the easiest
thing. That's the easiest
thing. You should keep those at home, just especially for lazy days, where you don't feel like thinking about how to make your food, right?
Right. You don't have to tamper it all that.
All right. Well, thank you so much for this recipe, Chef Dwain.
Yes, man. And next month, we're going to do the curry goat. Get goat and get your calendar. The calanda are out. It's curry goat. Go get your calanda. The recipe is
curry goat. Look at the excitement over there. There you go.
I know. We're going to bring it on. We'll bring it on curry goat style, all right?
So you know exactly what to expect in your next Grace Flavor with a Beat. We'll take a break and we'll be back in a few. Stay tuned.
Grace and You Cooking Show segment was brought to you by Grace Kennedy Belize Limited, bringing good taste to life.